Welcome back to OneStopTutorials.com. Alibaba is back again. We're back with Photoshop. We're using the image eyes_open.jpg. Okay, this is from that folder that you downloaded from our website, OneStopTutorials.com. Go there, you'll see a link for beauty course, and then you'll be able to download this folder and follow along. Now, as you can see, we have an image here. And our purpose in this tutorial is to get rid of this blood veins, okay, and actually make this whole eyeball more white, okay. There is two eyeballs on this actual image, but for the sake of time, I'm pretty much only going to be able to probably do one. So to make this work, what we need to do this is, we need to do this in stages, okay. Now the first stage I want to do is I want to delete out these redness around this eye, okay. When it comes to cloning, it's going to be a little bit harder. So I just want to get rid of the redness. The way to do this is come down to your layers adjustment here, this little circle with a line for it, left click on that. And we want to choose hue and saturation. You'll notice it's made us a new layer with a mask. You can double left click on this icon here. This will bring up the hue and sat dialog box, okay. Now what I want to do is, as we're dealing with reds, is I want to come into the reds channel here, okay. Now in Photoshop CS4, I forget if CS3 has it, but there's this little icon here which will allow you to turn to an eyedropper, okay. What I want to do is I want to select the red, okay. I'm just going to left click on that red selection, and then that'll now allow me to desaturate. This is pretty much all I really want to do. I just want to desaturate out the color of that red, okay. And once I'm happy with that, yep, that looks good to me. Next thing I want to do is I now want to make a new layer. Now I've desaturated some of this redness out, so it doesn't show so much. I want to come down to this icon here, select a new layer, okay. Now once I have this new layer, I want to grab myself the clone tool, which is here, or the shortcut is S on your keyboard, okay. I want to grab the clone tool. The next thing I want to do is I want to make sure my blend mode is to lighten, okay. This will allow us to lighten out the darker areas, in our case these veins, okay. And I want opacity, I'm going to move the opacity up, I'm going to make it about 70%, that's fine. Lighten, and I want to make sure that, yep, that's fine. So all I'm going to do, the way this works is you simply just hold down Alt or Option on your keyboard. You'll notice that the cursor changes, and that means we're allowed to select an area. So you would just left click selecting the area, and then you would just paste that into that new area. So that's all we're going to be doing. We're just going to be holding down Alt and Option all the time, selecting these veins and going through one by one just to delete out and make this veins not show, okay. So just coming through bit by bit, deleting it out. I'm not so concerned about this area so far. I can come back in and fix that. I'm pretty happy with that. The veins are pretty much gone. I'm going to move over to the other side, and I'm going to do this same. I'm just going to work my way through, clicking and pasting. Okay, again, you can move your brush size up if you wish. Just going to select. And it's going to look not so good at this point, but it really doesn't matter, because we're going to come in with a healing brush, and we're actually going to make this look a lot better, okay. Just selecting, clicking and drag, just select and paste, okay. That's all I'm doing. And I can see I need to come around this section here, okay. Now what I might do here is I might lower the opacity. If I hit 3 on my keyboard, you'll notice it changes the opacity to 30. And what I want to do is just come into this edge here. Just want to make it just a little bit more, less opacity, just so I can really get in there and make it not look so not real. Okay, so I mean, at the moment, yeah, like you see it's not looking 100% good, but it will be in a minute. So I'm going to come back over this side, and I'm going to do the same over here. I'm just going to use a section and just bring this out just a little bit. I want to bring these whites back, okay. Don't want to be doing it at a high opacity. There we go. So that's looking good for stage one. That's pretty much, we got rid of the veins. This is before, this is after. Okay, so we're looking good, okay. I'll tell you what we didn't actually do before. We didn't actually invert this selection, okay. You'll notice that we still have that gray look. The way to invert this mask is, okay, just click on the mask, hold down Control or Command on your keyboard, and hit the letter I, and that will now invert the desaturation that we had before. Okay, that was a stage that I forgot to do. That was a rookie's thing. Okay, so this is the before and after. We're getting those whites back. We're moving it around. It's starting to look good. Next thing I want to come into is I want to come into the healing brush tool, okay? And all I want to do is healing brush tool works in exactly the same way. It's a clone stamp. You just click and you drag. And what this will do is this will allow us to add a bit more life back to this eye so it doesn't look so man-made, should I say. Okay, we want to make sure that we're on the actual correct layer. We're on the top layer here. Just click, paste. That's all we're going to do. Find yourself made a mistake. Just come back. It's coming. It doesn't like this section here. Okay, we're going to have to come back in there with the clone tool. And we're just going to basically want to show you the technique of just clicking and just making this look a little bit softer and making it look a bit more real. I'm going to zoom out. You're going to get an effect. It's before, it's after. Okay. Now to make these eyes more white, what we need to do is we need to actually make these eyes into a selection. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to do that on a quick mask mode. Okay. We're going to come into quick mask. You can either hit this box here or you can hit Q on your keyboard. We're going to grab the paintbrush tool and we're going to have black as the foreground color and we're going to paint. If you're not sure what quick mask is, basically it allows us to paint a selection and then at a later date we can come back. What we can do is leave this quick mask mode and it will make it into a selection for us. Don't worry if you find yourself doing what I'm doing and going completely mental with it. You can always come back in and we can edit it. Okay, I'm just making a rough selection just because I've got to get these tutorials done in 10 minutes for YouTube. And what I'll do is I'll flip the foreground and background color off by hitting X on my keyboard. And now I'm going to come in. I'm just going to delete around the eyeball. I don't need it to be inside of the eyeball. Okay, I just want to whiten up the white. I don't want to be whitening up and just clean up down here a bit, along there a bit, up here a bit. A lot better if you actually, you know, do it right the first time. But if you're like me, you're a messy painter, then you have that option. Okay, so that is fine. We've made a selection. To exit the quick mask mode, simply hit Q on your keyboard, and there we go. Now, at the moment, what I want to do is I want to invert this selection. You'll notice that everything here is selected except for the eyeball. The way to do that is hold down Control Shift, or that is Command Shift on a Mac, and hit the letter I. That will invert it. So now we have just the eyeball selected. Next thing I want to do is I want to come up to the lasso tool because this will allow me to do the right click option that I want. I want to add a feather, and I want to add a feather with the 3 pixels just to make it look a bit better and have it a little bit more feathered. Okay, so we are starting to look good. Next thing I want to do is I want to make sure the top layer is selected. I want to come down to our adjustments and I want to choose curves. And you'll notice now that when I move this curves dialog box, it moves the eyes itself. Okay, it makes the eyes whiter. Again, commonly eyes are not white. Okay, people just generally don't have white eyes. Okay, so I just want it to be a little bit. I'm going to move it a bit higher, and that will mean now I can come with my opacity. I just want to bring some of that out. I don't want it to be so obvious. I want to obviously make it look a little bit whiter, but I don't want it to be so obvious. So I'm going to zoom out to let me zoom in one as well. Okay, this is the birth. Let me come down. This is the before. And then this is the after. So you're sort of getting the understanding. I could do with spending more time on this, getting this opacity, making sure that I've painted these eyes correctly, you know, getting in there with my quick mask, or now I've got a mask selected, I can now delete edges and make it more whiter. This is just a quick technique on showing you how to make these eyes whiter. We managed to get rid of the blood veins inside of the eyes. And now we've added this effect, and to be honest, it's probably still too bright. But if you bring the opacity down, it just brings back a bit more. We could probably spend a bit more time in here, coming up around here, and making this area look a bit more real. But you're getting a general understanding of how this works. Any of this can be edited at any time, just simply by grabbing the brush tool and using black as the foreground. And that will allow you to take stuff out, and then by using white as the foreground, you can then add stuff to it. Take it easy, guys and girls. I hope you get an understanding of what we're trying to do. This is the before. This is the after. Take it easy, everyone.